Welcome back. In this technology-dominated era, change seems to happen in a blink. Yet one young Chinese woman is using technology to preserve the old way. And with it, she's gone viral, not just in China, but worldwide. Through her videos, Chinese video vlogger Li Ziqi opens a window onto the slow-paced yet seemingly fairy tale existence of rural life in Sichuan Province in southwestern China. She makes everything from scratch, by hand, and from local ingredients, from cooking Sichuan cuisine and traditional papermaking, to weaving cloth, to homemade dresses, and even building a sofa from bamboo. In the ultra-competitive field of online videos, Li Ziqi has become a phenomenon, attracting more than 21 million fans on Chinese social media and another 8 million followers on YouTube. So one video there of her preparing exquisite snacks for the Chinese Spring Festival has been viewed over 40 million times. So to what degree is Li Ziqi successfully, quote, exporting Chinese culture? On the other hand, with her graceful elegance, is she also misrepresenting the hardship of Chinese rural life? Well, I'm pleased to be joined in our Beijing studio by Professor Li Jinzhao of the Beijing Foreign Language University and Dr. Dong Yiqun from Beijing Foreign University, Studies University. Thank you for joining us, to you both. So first of all, we want to show some of the videos of Li Ziqi. Take a look at this. So it seems that she does everything, literally everything, from scratch. There you see she hatches baby ducklings, raises them, and then collects the duck eggs to make a sauce from the egg yolk. And in another video, she builds an entire bamboo furniture set, designing the furniture, sawing the bamboo, then assembling it all with her own hands. She also makes her own clothes and makeup. She also comes up with this brilliant idea, you're looking at it, to make Chinese traditional lipstick and blush using roses from her garden, lemonade and honey, dyeing the color in sliced paper. Looks pretty, and even the talk of it, it's so beautiful. But let me get your thoughts on this. Mm-hmm. Professor Li first. Mm-hmm. Have you watched the videos from Li Ziqi? What do you think of it?
Yes, definitely. I totally enjoyed it when I watched a lot of episodes. Actually, probably two-thirds of all the episodes she made. And I have to admit that it was really a guilty pleasure while watching it, because I know that she is romanticizing rural China, the life in the villages. But on the other hand, it's really soothing, it's really relaxing, it's actually therapeutic to watch her making things.
I feel the same. I looked into some of her video too. I found some of the video was incredibly soothing, and the
right.
sound of mountain is very delightful. Professor Dong, your thoughts on this?
Yeah, actually I was introduced to Li Ziqi and her videos by my 90 generation friends. Uh-huh. And then I watched it and I found that it's such an amazing experience for me, because what a knowledge deficit that I had about the traditional life, the culture, and it's so amazing to observe a girl, a young girl who loves life so much and who is so real. Mm. And also I had a very good time since I start to watch and follow Li Ziqi, that I have more common topics with my younger friends.
Mm-hmm. Now, she's got over 21 million followers on Chinese social media, Weibo, and also nearly 8 million followers on YouTube. But think about it, the short video industry is extremely competitive, and a
right.
lot of people kind of does the same kind of video with the same theme, going back to rural life when, you know, city life is too much, is too stressful. Mm-hmm. But why is she so popular in particular? Mm-hmm. What made it work?
I guess there are several elements in her videos that made it really appealing universally. First, the universal love for food. Who can resist the food? And also handmade. So the handicrafts of everything from making from scratch. And thirdly, it is also this, I think, universally shared anxiety of over-modernization, urbanization, and the people's urge of having a quiet life, having more natural-oriented life. So I think these are the themes that commonly sensed and commonly felt by people across countries and continents.
And Professor, is it surprising to you that she's also popular, massively popular overseas? I mean, why is she so popular over overseas web users.
Right. Besides, I agree with Professor Lee, and I will add a few points. That firstly, I think that it's her dedication that she keeps producing videos with good quality, and every topic is well chosen, and also the audience don't need language background and a cultural background, so it won't kill their interests. And also the topics like the lotus powder or the noodles are very common things people really observe, really have it every day. But at the same time, the way she produces it, them, or the ingredients that she involves into the making, are some more often than not are good surprises.
And speaking of the background of her follower, when you take a look at it, where they are from, the top six countries, this is according to Web TV Asia, are actually Vietnam, the U.S., India, Indonesia, Thailand, and the Philippines. I mean, the U.S. accounted for 11% of the total number of subscribers. Is that surprising to you?
I'm not surprised. Actually, I read similar reports on the on her audiences and the followers, and I think because her ingredients are more similar, the cuisine in China are more widely shared in Southeast Asia, and also in terms of viewers, I think it has the snowball effect. You have friends being abroad, and then they will share the videos, they will let the others know, and particularly at the first stage, her videos were not captioned in English language, so yeah, so I think the Chinese speaking audience could follow more easily, could appreciate more wholly, but after her videos are translated in into English with English subtitles, I think she would win a broader audience from Africa, from Europe.
But when you take a look at the top 10 countries where her followers are from, most of them are actually Asian countries, with Vietnam marking the first.
Right.
So when you look at it, Dr. Dong, does it mean that his videos is appealing more to Asian viewers with similar cultural backgrounds?
Well, actually, I would say yes and no. So yes, because definitely the audience, the majority of them, are with Asian cultural background, or they are exposed to Asia, Asian culture. No, because I was curious, because why I couldn't find Japan and Korea, which are more culturally connected to Chinese culture, and at the same time they have more advanced entertainment industry and the internet netizens. So also I'm a little bit curious about why they are not on the top.
That's a good question. Yeah.
And her videos also cover a wide variety of craftsmanship related to traditional Chinese culture. Take a look at this. For example, she successfully made paper in traditional Chinese way in one video. That's it right there. Well, in another, she wove clothes to make a silk quilted comforter for her grandmother. In her last video, she even brewed soy sauce from scratch. So now she's been seen in some Chinese media as a role model for introducing Chinese culture to the world. Do you share that kind of view?
Yeah, but I'm kind of really reluctant to use the word exporting Chinese culture. That sounds very too much goal-oriented. I think she's just enjoying, and she's doing what she is capable of doing the most. And she does not do any preaching. I think that's the appealing part. She does not boast anything. She does not brag. And she doesn't even use melodramatic soundtrack to enhance the nuances or the ambience. She was just there doing things very quietly. So
what about some of the criticisms? I think Dr. Lee just mentioned earlier, let me get your thoughts on this, Dr. Dong. So some are saying that she isn't representing Chinese rural life
at all.
It's too graceful, way too exquisite and fairy tale-like. For example, a Chinese farmer probably would never pick up a rose on a horseback wearing red cape. So what do you think? Is there something wrong with her way of demonstrating China's rural life?
I would argue that she's definitely not the majority, or cannot be representative in terms of the everyday rural life, but I would say she provides a very interesting perspective to create life, to be more creative towards very trivial and ordinary things in rural China. So I think the spirit and also the belief about life and of her very positive attitude towards family bond, so on and so forth, are something that we should learn from her and from that's the heritage of the rural culture in China.
Yeah, I agree. I just actually came back from my field work into three rural places in Hainan. I went to a township, I went to a village, and also I went to a farm. Actually, the roads and the sceneries in the rural places are not that beautiful or picturesque, because you always find roads very dusty or muddy, and there will be a lot of motorbikes parked along roadsides, and a lot of construction left over or waste thrown away all over. So it's not that clean.
Yeah.
And there will be dilapidated rural schools or squares. So she's just presenting the most beautiful. I think she, to a certain extent, she's romanticizing it, but that's what we want to watch, we want to see.
And you're right, she never labeled herself as an exporter of Chinese culture. And we have some comments from viewers. I just want to run that real quick. This is the comments from viewers. Quote, no matter how I need and love technology, this is the life I always dream, free from debt, free from worries, free from expectations. I mean, what do these comments say? Why they like so much about her? I mean, in understanding this, we might be able to learn how to better facilitate understandings between different cultures and avoid mishaps, right?
I think it's this inner call of modern peoples for the simple life, the yearning for a simple life, the life that people wanted deep down in their heart and also through their stomach, and she is realizing that kind of a dream kind of life for everyone, so that makes her so appealing.
Dr. Dong, very briefly, is it easy to duplicate her success though?
I would say that I would suggest, if I were one of the viewers, I would enjoy her story and move along. And well, when we live our own life and stay positive, we are also telling a very unique and a positive story.
Yes.
Well said. Thank you very much. We're going to have to leave it there. Thank you for insights and perspectives.
Thank you.
And that's going to do it for this edition of The Point on CGTN. Thank you so much for watching. We hope to see you same time tomorrow. And we're going to leave it there. Bye for now.